Viewers and subscribers, it's the time of the year where the Malaysian boulevards, streets and parks are lined with this beautiful blossom of our version of the sakura tree. Viewers, we're going to learn how to shoot the beautiful Tacoma blossom of Malaysia in this lesson. But first, some backstories on the Tacoma. The Tacoma tree, or the rosy trumpet tree, originated from Central or South America. Now, the Tacoma tree thrives and grows very well in warm climate countries. And that is why the Tacoma can be found abundantly in Malaysia. And here are a few interesting things about the Tacoma. In Malaysia, we have a few species available. You have the pink-coloured Tacoma, and the white-coloured Tacoma, and also the yellow-coloured Tacoma. When it blooms, it will bloom on the warmest time of the year, which is typically March and April in Malaysia. And here is the beautiful thing about Tacoma. When they bloom, they will bloom the whole tree of flowers. And when you look at them, they really look like the sakura tree in Japan blooming. In fact, if you ask me, it's even nicer because there are so many variants in color. And here is a beautiful thing about Tacoma. When the flower is at its plumose bloom, it will drop when the wind blows and cover all the grounds where the trees are, making it look like colorful snow. Oh, an important thing you must know. If you're shooting Tacoma and you're bringing your pets, make known that the yellow Tacoma specifically is toxic. The plant should not be ingested, so please avoid your pets eating them. Oh, there's one more thing. When the Tacoma drops on the ground, they can be beautiful. But after a few days, they will disintegrate and rot and become like this. And this can be a nuisance if you're riding motorcycle, because they can actually be very slippery on the road. So if you're riding your motorcycle and passing by Tacoma trees with such flowers on the ground, be careful. Setting up your camera, the first thing that I'll strongly suggest that you change is your camera's color space. Well, most modern cameras would have two color spaces at least for you to choose, which is the sRGB and the Adobe RGB. What's the difference? Take a look at these two diagrams here. You notice that color space is how much the camera can actually see and capture in your photo. The sRGB, while it's being a more common color space and available for most devices and screens and cameras, it's a smaller color space compared to Adobe RGB. So here's the rule that I use. If I'm shooting anything colorful and nature related, where there's blue and green, if you look at this, the Adobe RGB would capture more green than anything else. So the Tacoma comes in pink, blue skies and green leaves. I'm changing to Adobe RGB. You've got more color to play with. Second thing, the picture control or the color styles of your camera. So what I'm gonna do with these color profiles, I'm gonna make the photo sharper. And at the same time, I'm gonna be changing the color more saturated, and at the same time, adding contrast to this. And when you do this, you're gonna be applying interesting filters to it, not unlike the filters that you have on your smartphone. No, this is boring. You are so tempted to look at the beautiful, colorful flowers, and then you forget to look at the background. If you do this wrongly, you're gonna end up with flower and plain background, same background the whole time. And this is what I want to tell you, tip number two, vary and change your background. If you do so, you're going to be rewarded with shots like this. Background with leaves, background with cloudy sky, background with blue skies, background with urban condominium settings. And have fun. It is not just blue sky the whole time. You probably think that the sun is behind me, and then the Tacoma flower is in front of me. I can see it so well with my eye, and this is what you get. When you take a shot, it's underexposed. Why? And here's the problem, you are actually in the shade. When you point up your camera, you're still in the shade. So the camera will perceive this as being dark, even though the sun is there. And here's what I want to share with you. You should have the sun behind your Tacoma flower, like this. And let me show you what happens when you do this correctly. The hell? Don't trust your exposure meter, because when the lights are so bright and so contrasty and there's only one sun coming from one direction, your exposure meter are going to be confused regardless what camera you use. So the best thing to do is to go to your playback and flip on your histogram. Take a look at this. The largest peak is always the sky. Make sure that it doesn't go above this column here. If it does, then you're overexposed. So mid-tone is somewhere about here. So make sure that your flowers, the Tacoma, fall somewhere here. So if you look at this shot, this is a good exposure. So if you look at this shot, this is overexposed, even though the screen tells you so. Make no mistake, even though the Tacoma flower can be correctly exposed, if the sky is overexposed, it will not look nice. And the next point, don't always point it up and start zooming maximum. Instead, breathe your composition. What do I mean by that? Get space, go on your widest wide angle. And then we're gonna do shots like this and like this. In the beginning of this video, you noticed that I plugged on a flash to my camera. I'm gonna show you why you should fire your flash even on a bright sunny day like this. Flashes are not meant for only night shots. So take a look at this. The flash is completely off. So I'm pointed to this beautiful composition now. And my exposure is slightly above zero like this. So if I take a shot now, it's gonna be slightly brighter than the usual mid-tone. This is how it looks like. Flat and boring. But if I turn on the flash, you can do two modes. You can go on TTL or I'm gonna use manual. So I'm gonna manually gauge what is the power I'm gonna use. So I'm turning this to 1/4 of a power and take a look at this. I am now gonna make my exposure negative a little bit so that I can darken the sky and boom. Compare the two pictures now. One with the flash, one without the flash. So when you add on the flash, the Tacoma gets a separation in brightness, which means that the background is slightly darker and the flowers are brighter. Here's the point. There is a tree here. And if my flash is pointed to here, it's the nearest foreground. It's gonna be bright. So remember this rule, don't have foreground like this bright because your eyes are gonna be attracted to it. So what I do, I turn the flash head to the side a little bit away from that foreground and focus much better. Top left, bottom left. This is called a down tilt. If you look at this branch of the Tacoma flower, it's going down. Nothing wrong with this composition, but as a commercial photographer, I'm rarely allowed to shoot a down tilt like this, as opposed to an up tilt. So if you look at these two pictures, you notice that one of it looks more going up. And going up is positivity. That's what we call the art of seeing. That means the composition at your best effort should go up. What do I mean by this? Simple. Lock the branch to the bottom left, like here. Don't have it up like so. So if you look at your viewfinder, if you want to have an up tilt, ensure that the branch is always locked to the bottom left of your viewfinder. And then you're going to get shots looking like so. That's an up tilt. And my last parting point to you on shooting the beautiful Tacoma, use the rule of golden points. What are golden points? Let me show you. So I've got a branch of Tacoma here on the blue sky. This is called golden point number 2. This is golden point number 1. This is golden point number 3, and this is golden point number 4. Confuse them not with rule of thirds. You use golden points when it comes to products or subjects which are really small. Head on to this video here and watch this really good explanation about golden points. So here's the thing. This branch is facing to my left, so I can take golden point number 2 and number 4. But how do I take golden point number 1 if I do it this way? It's not going to look so nice because of the other branches. So what I do, I go the other side. So now, when I'm opposite of where I was, I can now get golden point number 1 and golden point number 3. Done. So take a look at 1 to 4. What you just learned is called compositional rules of photography. And in arts and designing and photography, we have all these rules compiled together, which is called the art of seeing. Head on to my website, check out this highly popular course. I think this is like our second most popular course, the art of seeing. Subscribe to this course because it's a promo now and we're revamping the whole entire collection of all the lessons in there. So you're going to get a course reboot. And this is the best time to subscribe to Art of Seeing, where you're going to learn compositional rules about closer, tilts, rule of thirds. What are the difference between rule of thirds and golden points? Why do you need space? When do you have to breathe the photo? So hurry, head onto my website and subscribe to the Art of Seeing e-learning. So viewers and subscribers, I hope you enjoyed this short lesson on how to shoot the Tacoma and photography. If you do, do two things for me. Subscribe to this channel. Don't just watch the video. Subscribe to this so that we have a bigger crowd and that way I can do more videos. And hit the bell button too. And secondly, please head on to my e-learning website. Check out my e-learning and also our premium courses and the collection of promos that we have there. So I'll see you in the next video.